This is from Roger Crayon, writing in from Ottawa, Washington. Here it is. I've been a part of a carpool for several years. Recently, I asked the main organizer, one of two drivers, for a breakdown of the charges he levies on each member. I was stunned to find out that he was effectively doubling the cost of each trip by charging for every conceivable cost of maintaining his car, including depreciation, tires, routine maintenance, and soon the cost of a new car. It's his car. Would he be driving to work each day regardless of whether there were other passengers or not. I feel that charging anything above gas and a driver charge is unfair. Sincerely, Roger Crayon from Ottawa, Washington. What do we think?
Well, what does Roger want? What is it?
Roger sounds like a cheap son of a gun. He wants to spend a little less money on his carpool.
Right. Hey, Roger, take the bus.
You hear that, Roger? Take that bus.
You got a problem with how much your driver wants to charge you?
Yeah, good luck getting a breakdown of the charges that the bus levies, am I right?
Can you imagine asking a carpool for a breakdown on the charge? Now, I do think carpooling is a pyramid scheme. It's its whole own independent problem.
I see.
But so long as you're going to partake in carpooling, Avon, Herbalife, all of the top ones.
Let me break that down. How exactly is carpooling a pyramid scheme? You think you get someone in your carpool, and then they have to carpool two of their friends?
Yeah.
And then those friends have to carpool their friends?
Oh, yes.
Okay, well,
I think.
I guess you're right. Go on.
I think that Roger should consider, first of all, not being so pathetic, but second of all, maybe getting his own car and then carpooling the people in Roger in the other guy's car that don't want to pay the same amount. You know what I mean?
Like
if you have a problem, if you have a problem with the cost, do it yourself.
If you have a problem with the cost, do it yourself. I think that is great advice for anything.
For anything. And then you'll see what you can and cannot actually do.
Let's side with Roger for a moment.
Oh boy, I can't.
I'm paying for this guy's tires. I'm paying for routine maintenance. I'm not messing up the car.
I'd love to know the charge.
I'd love to know the charge. I wish he left
Surely
a specific number.
Exactly. That would have made everything clearer. The distance, the cost. I'd like to do some math, if that's okay.
Absolutely. Here, I'll give you a calculator.
Thank you.
And there you go. Too much. She just spelled boobies. Thanks a lot, Michelle. I think you could say that on the radio.
Classic.
We're talking about the blue-footed, which is a bird.
Right.
So there's always a way around swearing, all right? Roger Crayon. Mason, what do you think Roger should do? Should he drop it?
Look, if he's gotten this far into this carpooling, he obviously has been paying this amount for, you know, X number of weeks, months, years, right? It's not out of his range of affordability, right? Because he's already been doing it. So at this point, asking for a breakdown, you know, unless it's the second week of carpooling, it's just ridiculous.
It's too late.
It's too late now.
And it's too late,
you think. You need to cut costs. You can't put that on somebody else.
Right. I agree.
Make other changes.
Yeah. Ooh, I'm a little surprised. I thought you'd side more with Roger. He's getting gouged.
No, we don't know how much he's paying.
He's getting swindled here.
Depends. No. It depends.
This could be $12 a week. We have no idea.
$12 a week? I could buy a lot of limes with that.
But it's still less than public transportation.
That's true. That would be cheaper than the bus. He could walk. How far is it? You know what I mean?
Well, let's be fair. Ottawa, Washington doesn't have a great system of transit. But you're right.
Good point.
You're right.
They're working on it.
Roger, get back to us with more information.
That's true. You know, that goes to Emily. Mm-hmm. That goes to, who was the other writer? Elaine, not Betty. You should write in with follow-ups, mm-hmm. you know? Mm-hmm. I'd like to know how our advice goes. Obviously, they're taking our advice.
Obviously.
Elaine is in the midst of faking her death right now.
Good. Good call.
Emily is confronting Tammy.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
But I have to say, Roger, I think you're onto something here.
I can't.
Well, maybe not. Here, Roger, let's try this. How do you two agree with this? Mm. How do you agree with this?
In what way do you agree?
That's a good question. Maybe Roger, because Roger does mention, I've been a part of a carpool for several years. You're right about that. Mm. Recently, I asked the main organizer, one of two drivers.
Okay, maybe a husband and a wife?
Maybe a husband and a wife, who knows?
Could be just two separate.
Maybe
yes,
a husband
true.
And a husband? Could maybe be. Maybe a wife and a wife. It's 2019, Michelle.
I'm sorry.
And that's how I feel superior to my guests.
So
several years, though?
Several
yeah, sorry,
years.
Sorry, Roger, but chill.
It's too late. You know what?
Car. Maybe
I'm starting
it's time
to...
for him to get a car.
So we are confirming that this is a pyramid scheme, then. There are already two drivers, and all that's happening is Roger is going to become his own carpool service under them.
I think carpooling, the problem with it is that it results in everybody having their own car because everybody gets frustrated.
Yeah.
So then we're just making it worse. That's...
And we forget about the chlorine.
The chlorine.
In the pool? Carpool? Oh, I misunderstood the question.
Shuffles papers nervously.
All right, let's... we have to go to another break here.